Hello students, welcome to physics class. Today we discuss law of conservation of energy. In the last session, we learned there are different type of energy and energy is the ability to do work. So energy can convert from one form to another form. But never we can destroy the energy. Even though if you are able to convert one form of energy into another form, we cannot destroy the energy or we cannot create an energy. We can only transform one form of energy into another form of energy. This is known as law of conservation of energy. Let's see the statement. According to law of conservation of energy, energy can neither be created or destroyed. It can only be converted from one form to another. Total energy before and after the transformation remains the same. This is known as law of conservation of energy. We can convert electrical energy into light energy. We can convert the light energy into electrical energy. So all this time, the energy conversion is taking place. But we are not creating a new energy. Only one form of energy is converted into another form. We are not able to destroy the energy. This is known as law of conservation of energy. That is, energy can neither be created or destroyed. It can only be converted from one form to another. But after the conversion, the total energy before and after the transformation remains the same. This is law of conservation of energy. And remember, the law of conservation of energy is valid in all situations and for all kind of transformations. The law of conservation of energy is obeyed, or the law of conservation of energy is valid in all situations and all kind of energy transformations. Let us see a simple example for the law of conservation of energy. Conservation of energy in a freely falling body. We know that what is a freely falling body. Once a body is falling under the gravitational force alone, we can call it as freely falling body. Consider such a free fall here. From a height h above the earth's surface, we are dropping a body of mass m. Say, this is a body of mass m. Right now it is at a height h above the earth's surface. Now it is at rest there. Its velocity is zero. Say initial velocity is zero. So at point A, what is the kinetic energy of that object? The kinetic energy of that object is equal to half mv square. As velocity is zero, kinetic energy at this point A is equal to zero. There is no velocity. The object is at rest there. Now, but it has a potential energy. Potential energy is equal to mgh. The last class we learned expression for the potential energy. It is equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity into height above the earth surface. So potential energy is equal to mgh. So total energy, potential energy plus kinetic energy, can be called as mechanical energy. Total mechanical energy, or total energy, is equal to kinetic energy at A plus potential energy at A. But kinetic energy is zero and potential energy is equal to mgh. So zero plus mgh, that's equal to mgh. That's the total energy at the point A. At point A, it have only potential energy, but kinetic energy is zero. Suppose if you're dropping the object from the, you are just dropping. Once you're dropping, initial velocity is zero and it falls under the gravity. We can call it as free fall. The object is falling under gravitational force, free fall. Suppose the object is, okay, just before touching the ground, okay, it reached at the point C, and just before touching the ground, it achieved a velocity V. Let's say it have a velocity V. So it gained a kinetic energy. The gain in kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Half mv square. Once it is falling down, its velocity gradually increases. Once it reaches the bottom point, it have a maximum velocity. It means once the ball or body is falling down, gradually its kinetic energy increases. But remember, once it is falling, the height decreases. Once height decreases, its potential energy decreases. So when the body is in free fall, kinetic energy gradually increases, potential energy is gradually decreases. So otherwise we can say its potential energy is converting into kinetic energy. Initially, it have potential energy only, no kinetic energy. But once the ball is falling, gradually its kinetic energy is increases, potential energy decreases. What actually happening is that its potential energy is converting into kinetic energy. The potential energy stored in this body is converted into kinetic energy. So suppose the body is reached at point C. Say its velocity at C is V. So its kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. But here at point C is at ground. So height is equal to zero. Once you are calculating the potential energy, H is equal to zero. So we can write H is equal to zero, potential energy equal to zero. So what is total energy at C? Mechanical energy, potential energy plus kinetic energy. And its total energy at C is equal to kinetic energy at C plus potential energy at C. Kinetic energy at C is half mv square, where v is the velocity at C, plus zero, potential energy zero as height equal to zero. So we get in total energy is equal to half mv square, half mv square. We got at A, total energy is equal to mgh. At C, total energy is equal to half mv square. But we can easily prove that half mv square is equal to mgh. Let us see that at C, if you are using the equations of motion, remember this equation of motion, that's v square is equal to u square plus 2as. V square is equal to u square plus 2as. What is v? Final velocity. U, initial velocity. A, acceleration. Here, the body is falling down, so we can write the acceleration as g, acceleration due to gravity. And s is the height above the Earth's surface, so we're writing h. So v square minus u square is equal, we are taking this u to left side, is equal to 2 into acceleration due to gravity. Here, the acceleration involved is acceleration due to gravity. So we can write as 2gh. Instead of s, we are writing height h, 2gh. So we are using that equation at C, v square minus u square is equal to 2gh. Once the object is dropping, initial velocity is 0. So v square minus 0 square is equal to 2gh, or v square is equal to 2gh. The square of velocity is equal to 2gh. Now substitute in the equation of kinetic energy at C. Kinetic energy at C is equal to half mv square. So half m into v square. V square is equal to 2gh. V square is equal to 2gh. That is equal to half m 2gh. So we're getting mgh. We proved half mv square is equal to mgh. That is, the total energy at A is equal to total energy at C. Once the object falling from A to C, total energy at A is equal to total energy at C. What does it mean? Energy is conserved. Total energy at A and C is same. Energy is conserved. And however, energy conversion is taking place. Initially, we have only potential energy. Once it is falling, potential energy gradually decreases, and once it reaches at C, entire potential energy is converted into kinetic energy. So, in between these two points, A and C, at any point, we can prove that potential energy plus kinetic energy will be a constant. During its path, potential energy plus kinetic energy will be constant at any point in this path. So, that is actually the conservation of energy. That is, during the free fall of the object, the decrease in potential energy at any point in its path appears as an equal amount of increase in kinetic energy. During the free fall of the object, the decrease in potential energy at any point in its path appears as an equal amount of increase in kinetic energy. That is the law of conservation of energy. Now let us see what is this quantity power. The power of a quantity is defined like this way. The power is defined as the rate of doing work. The time taken to complete a work by different agent will be different. So another quantity which measure the rate of work done is known as power. The rate at which the work is done is known as power. If an agent does a work W in a time T, then its average power is given by power is equal to work by time. If an agent takes a very small time to complete a work, we can say it have a good power or it have a large power. So power and time are inversely proportional. Power is equal to work by time. The SI unit of power is the SI unit of work by SI unit of time. Joule per second. Joule divided by second. Joule per second. And the joule per second is also known as watt. It's the name of scientist. In order to honor that scientist, the unit of power is taken as watt. The symbol is capital W. Capital W is the symbol of watt. And 1 joule per second is equal to 1 watt. 1 joule per second is equal to 1 watt. It means the power of an agent is 1 watt if it does a work at the rate of 1 joule per second. If an agent is able to complete 1 joule of work in 1 second, then we can say that the power of that agent is 1 watt. The power of an agent is 1 watt if it does a work at the rate of 1 joule per second. And instead of this watt, we have some bigger unit of power. They are kilowatt. Kilowatt. And it is represented as KW. Capital K, capital W. Kilowatt. 1 kilowatt means 1000 watt. Megawatt. 1 megawatt is equal to 10 raised to 6 watt. Like as horsepower. 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watt. These are the some bigger units of power. Now let us see a commercial unit of energy. You know the SI unit of energy is joule. But joule is a too small unit. For the measurement of large energy, we can use some other unit other than this joule. Such a unit is kilowatt hour. Kilowatt hour. We know that power is equal to work by time or power is equal to energy by time. So we can write energy is equal to power into time. Energy is equal to power into time. So the unit of energy is equal to unit of power into time. So watt second is equivalent to joule. So but if you are using the bigger unit of power and the bigger unit of time, we get kilowatt into hour. The bigger unit of energy is kilowatt into hour. Let's see what is 1 kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour is equal to first 1 kilowatt. How many watt? 1000 watt. Then 1 hour. 1 hour is equal to 3600 second. So if you are multiplying 1000 into 3600, that's 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 36 lakhs. We get 36 lakhs. So 1 kilowatt hour can be write as 36 lakhs joule. Or it's equal to 3.6 into 10 raised to 6 joule. That's a bigger unit of energy. Energy, the bigger unit or commercial unit of energy is kilowatt hour. No, 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 into 10 raised to 6 joule. That's 1 kilowatt hour. That's all today. Thank you.